This is a video on the calculator function LinRegTTest. This is typically used when you are looking for a correlation between two variables. So we have an example here. We have 10 men, and from those men, they looked at their fat consumption per day, as well as their cholesterol level. So we want to find out, is there a correlation between fat consumption per day and cholesterol level? And LinRegTTest can do that for us. So you'll want to first go to stat and then edit, and then you want to put your values into two lists. So fat consumption is going to go into one list, cholesterol level is going to go into another list. You want to make sure that for each person, in this case, the fat consumption corresponds to their cholesterol level. So for the first person, they had a fat consumption of 55 grams, cholesterol level is 180. So I make sure that those are across from one another. And I double check and make sure all my numbers are right. Even one number that's wrong can change everything. So now once I have that, I go stat over to tests. LinRegTTest is down at the bottom. So the easiest thing for me to do is to press the up arrow. And you can see that by doing that, I find LinRegTTest, it is F on my calculator. I press enter. And then I just tell the calculator a few things. My fat consumption is in list one and my cholesterol level is in list two. So I tell the calculator that. Frequency, it is one, that's default, don't touch it. For the hypothesis test, you do want a not equal to zero. And then we are ready to calculate. So we get quite a few values here. I'll tell you what they are, but not all of them are needed. So up at the top, you're given the form for the best fit line, y equals a plus bx. And right here, this is a test statistic as well as a p-value. So if you're using the p-value method, these values would be needed for your hypothesis test. The next thing is the degrees of freedom. That is simply the number of data values you have. It's technically 10 people. Minus 2, that gives you 8. The next thing you see is A, which is the value that's going to go here in the regression equation, as well as B, which is going to go here in the regression equation. So if you're creating the best fit line for your data, you're going to simply take A and B and plug those into here. Typically, it's using three significant figures to round it. The next value, S, is standard error. Typically not used very much. So down at the bottom, you have R squared and R. I have to read R squared. I just don't have it memorized. R squared is the proportion of the variation in Y that can be explained by the linear relationship between X and Y. The value R is really the one that's used the most because that is a measure of the strength of the correlation. The closer it is to 1 or negative 1, the stronger the correlation. So typically that's compared with the Pearson correlation coefficient to make a determination on whether or not there is evidence to support a linear relationship. So those are all the values from LinRegTTest. Good luck.